Hi everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Scott's Soldiers. I hope the summer has been good to you, that you managed to grab some good weather and get outdoors and find time to do some other things. I want to share with you my sets, and that's plural, of Canada's Governor General's Foot Guards. This regiment has been around for a long time, or at least long in terms of Canadian regiments. The Guards' history dates back to 1872, and its members have served with the Nile Expeditionary Force to relieve General Gordon at Khartoum, the Northwest Rebellion, the South African War, World War I, and World War II. Today, the Guards remain a primary reserve regiment located in Ottawa, Ontario, the national capital of Canada. Most Canadians and visitors to Ottawa in the summertime are familiar with the regiment in its ceremonial role of guarding the official residence of the Governor General of Canada and with its musical ceremony on Parliament Hill. My figures come from Soldiers, Britons, and Spirit of the Empire. They represent the regiment at various times in its history and, like other Canadian military figures, can be a challenge to collect. I'm going to start with the Britons figures, as the company was the first to produce figures of the regiment. These are set number 1634, which according to James Opie had a production run from 1938 to 41 and then resumed 1946 to 65. Several of mine are also marked déposé on the base, a reference used by Britons in relation to figures made in France or for the French market. Check out my episode 8 for more details, but these are not Paris office, rather the result of Britons repurposing old molds for new production runs. Britons made versions of all the British Guards regiments, and the Governor Generals are based on its earlier Coldstream Guards. However, the Governor General's Foot Guards are distinct in that they have the red plumes on the left side of the bearskin cap. That's the left side, and it's red. Other than that, these are pretty straightforward. This set can be difficult to find, but if you look hard enough, they sometimes turn up at shows. These figures have taken me several years to amass and are in relatively good shape. Note how the bases are two different shades of green, and the tunics are also two different shades of red. The bayonet frogs are painted on the figures on dark green bases, but not the lighter green. Also, the rifles have different bayonets. The dark green base has a pointed bayonet suggesting pre-war, while the spade bayonet on the lighter green is post-war. If you think it can't get any weirder, take a look at the bases. At least three different versions in a production run. These are from John Tunstall's Soldiers. I bought these directly from John about 10 years ago. He had done a wide variety of British and Empire figures, and at the time, I think these were almost the last of his stock of Canadian figures. So if we begin with the bases, you can see the unique info. It says, Soldiers, John Tunstall, copyright, Lambeth, England, and the number of the sets, in this case, number 110 and 34. Although John had indicated that these were recorded as C-134. The set number C-34F is the modern guards in their ceremonial uniforms with bearskin cap and, of course, red plume on the left side. Next is set number 110 of the guards in greatcoats. And if you've ever experienced a Canadian winter, you know these greatcoats are mandatory winter wear. This too would have been an easy set to make, as he would have simply taken a British Guard set, painted the red plume on, and voila, set 110 was created. These are slightly heavier than other soldiers figures, and they are also done in a flat paint finish. But the set has an NCO holding a board or sheaf of papers in the hand, as if taking a roll call or reading out the orders of the day. The following are from Spirit of the Empire. They are modern renditions of the Guard. I've spoke about a number of sets done by Spirit, and the Guards are no exception. These two officers with drawn swords are numbered GG1. The next grouping are six guardsmen at attention, number GG2. And as promised, here are the bases. The year 2002 is the year of production. I had the chance to go to the Guards' Cartier Drill Hall in Ottawa. Outside, there was this old universal gun carrier out front, not in the best of shape, as well as a statue to those who fought in the Northwest Rebellion of 1873. This summer, renovations are taking place on Parliament Hill, which have severely reduced the ground space available for festivities, including what used to be the changing of the Guards ceremony. This year, it is now simply called Canada on the March, and it is a music-only version of the ceremony. But there were plenty of personnel from the Foot Guards to answer questions and greet the spectators. The following photos and videos capture the ceremonial guard and its band, a subunit within the Governor General's Foot Guard.
For this year's return of the Ceremonial Guard, Awakening by Major Vincent Roy. Following the fanfare, the band will perform our national anthem and all are welcome to sing along if you know the words. Highlanders, in June of 1848, when his regiment left Gibraltar for service in Canada, the band of the Ceremonial Guard will now perform a powerful combined rendition of the 79th Farewell to Gibraltar.
Le 79th Farewell to Gibraltar se classe parmi les plus belles marches de Cornemuse à avoir été composées. Il s'agissait d'un des premiers airs de Cornemuse pour les militaires en marche. La pièce a été composée en juin 1848 par le cornemuseur-major John MacDonald, des 79th Cameron Highlanders lorsque son régiment a quitté Gibraltar pour aller servir au Canada. La musique étendra maintenant une interprétation combinée de The 79th Farewell to Gibraltar.
Thank you.
Well, thanks for watching, and please hit the like or subscribe buttons to help the channel grow. Until next time, keep collecting.